Welcome to the Lumbridge Knights Hardcore Ironman series, and in this episode we will be looking at my first foray into members and what I did as soon as I crossed those gates into Seer's Village and entered the world of peer-to-play OSRS. Hello and welcome, we've reached that time again where I update you on the progress that my Hardcore Ironman has made. This update is probably going to be quite a brief update, just covering the first few steps in the members world. That's right folks, I have finally used that bond and upgraded my account to membership. As per the last video where I alluded to some of my targets, I kind of laid out that basically one of the first things I wanted to do was to hit Wintertodt. And, you know, there's a big reason to do that. As a hardcore Ironman, it's much harder to sell things to make money, because without use of the Grand Exchange, it just makes life a little bit difficult. And Wintertodt sets you up with a nice supply crate. You know, there's a chance of getting a Dragon Axe, along with a load of supplies, you know, seeds and things for Herbology, etc. Herbology? Is Harry Potter? Herblore. Glad we cleared that one up. And basically, I just wanted to kind of give you a quick update on what I'd done as soon as I crossed that threshold into members. As you can probably see on the channel, I've made a couple more guide videos for free-to-play. If you are still in the free-to-play world and you're just interested in some end-game tips as well as other things you can do to kind of keep free-to-play fresh and interesting, if you want to check those videos out, I'll drop a link up on the screen. Moving on to actual progress then. So what's the first thing I did? Well, the first thing I did was obviously to prep for Wintertodt. Now what you need for Wintertodt was 50 firemaking, which you can see from the last video and the images on screen. I currently already had 50 firemaking. I knew this in advance and that's why I prepped it. Druidic ritual is like right, you know, straight through the door of the members world. So if you go through the gate opposite Dorak's anvils, Druidic ritual is just there on the right hand side. There's also the Witch's House quest, which gives you a nice amount of HP experience. I did both of those. And I've just been kind of prepping up the other bits and pieces. So I've bought a house. I haven't done anything to it because construction is one of the most expensive skills to level up. So I need to kind of generate some significant funds with my Hardcore Ironman if I'm going to kind of pursue that one. I do plan on still having this like Homes Under the Hammer ripoff sort of joke updates in the future, hopefully. Fingers crossed that we kind of still work on that. Once I'd kind of prepped all that stuff and got some warm clothing, I'm using the anti-Santa suit because I think it's cool. I was then ready to take on Wintertodt, but before I did that, I really wanted to kind of make sure that I had kind of open access to the rest of the members world. So I've been looking at, I mentioned it in the last one, that I wanted to do some achievement diaries. So I think the most important achievement diaries to do first off the bat are Lumbridge and Ardougne. Ardougne gives you a teleport to the monastery just south of Ardougne, so you can recharge your prayer very easily, and also it's kind of like right next to the city, so it's kind of like a free Ardougne teleport. I've got enough magic to unlock the actual Ardougne teleport, but that needs a quest. That's something else I did. So I did the Plague City quest to unlock that. Tree Gnome Village quest, as this opens up the Spirit Tree teleports. I also did the Lost City quest, and this is the first one on the route to open up the Fairy Rings. You need to complete the Fairy Tales 1 and 2 quests in order to fully access the Fairy Ring network. So I'm working on that at the moment, haven't finished it. Working on it, there's quite a few skill requirements I don't quite meet yet, so I've not really got round to them yet. I also crafted a lot of games necklaces and Rings of Duelling. This is just to give me some other easy additional teleports, and also the games necklace is one of the prep steps for Wintertodt, because you can teleport right to the Wintertodt camp, so that's really useful. As of today, right now, I've just completed my first 5 rounds of Wintertodt. Didn't get anything significant from the drops, boo-hoo, but I did get into my groove and kind of understand that. And despite a lot of the guides saying that you should do it when you're really low HP, I've got like 70 HP or something, so I'm really not in that bracket anymore. But I do have like 400 tuna that I fished as the byproduct of when I was fishing swordfish to go fight Obor when I was still free to play. So I've got like 400 tuna that just is sat in my bank doing nothing. So I thought I may as well try and use that. And to be fair, it's pretty much good enough. I can get through 2 rounds, no problem, with like half an inventory of food. So that's gonna last me probably well into level 60 or 70. So that's pretty good. The actual boss itself, Wintertodt, is, you know, it's very easy to get into the swing of it. And it's also very easy to take your eye off the ball. I managed to get hit by 2 of the avalanche style splash damage attacks, which hit me for like 20 odd damage. So it's quite scary when you see your character go down like 30 HP. Well, it's scary for a hardcore Ironman anyway. So you really need to keep your concentration up when you're doing that, which is going to make the grind to 99 quite difficult. I'll show it in the video. You can see that my first five crates were not great. I didn't get much from the supply crates, but it's going to be the first of many. Hopefully, I'm going to have an absolute shed load. My plan at the moment is to keep opening them until I can get the full Pyromancer outfit. Once I've got the full Pyromancer outfit, I'll be stocking them up and opening them as I level through the other skills in the game. So the contents of the crate is relevant to the level that you are in the skills when you open it. So it's best to stash them. Open the ones to start with to try and get the Pyromancer outfit, because that gets you additional firemaking XP, and obviously it's going to make the task a little bit easier. But after that, it's best to stack the crates as much as you can. Obviously it might fill my bank, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Please like the video and support my Ironman content. Thank you. One additional thing I did, and this was mainly for the achievement diaries, was the tourist trap quest. It was a bit of a pain. There's quite a bit of running around in the desert, but it was quite easy. It was just a pain in terms of if you muck up the mechanics slightly, you end up getting like shot in jail or moved out to the desert in the middle of nowhere type thing, and there's a lot of running. It was a bit of a pain. However, the reward is two lots of 4,650 XP in either agility, fletching, smithing, or thieving. I used one on agility and one on thievery. This got both skills up to level 20, which gave me enough to complete the Lumbridge achievement diary. So I managed to get the Explorer's Ring 1, which is useful because that gives you a twice a day 50% run recharge, as well as 30 low level alchemies. I really need to get the medium diary done as well to get the Explorer's Ring 2, as that gives you 3 daily teleports to the cabbage patch near Faldor and 50% run replenish 3 times a day instead of 2. I need to complete the Animal Magnetism quest, as well as the Fairy Tale 2, which I mentioned earlier, as quests that I'm working on. So I haven't quite got around to them, but it's good to break things up. So I'll do Wintertodt until I get sick of that, and then I'll kind of come out and do a bit of questing. And basically, you know, that's where my hardcore Ironman is up to at the moment. Overall then, if I'm going to comment on my short time as a member, obviously I was a member some 20 odd years ago, so I've come back into the game now. It's massive, and I was totally overwhelmed for the first probably 2 days, 3 days of my membership, and I just ended up kind of like having so many things to do. I didn't know what to do, so I just started like doing quests and asked a few people in the clan Discord what their advice was about what to do to get going with my hardcore Ironman, and they did give me some good advice. Because of that, and because of that feeling I had of just being totally overwhelmed by how much content there was, I'm actually working on a video, first things to do for new members. So if that's ready, I will put that on the screen and link it in the description. So I definitely recommend you checking that out, either just before you go members or just after you've gone members, because it's not a nice feeling when you don't know what to do and there's just so much stuff to do, you don't know where to start. Hopefully that'll give you some hints and tips, and hopefully you're enjoying this hardcore Ironman journey, and long may it continue all the way to that fire making skill cape, then the quest cape, and then, you know, maybe even the max cape. So something I wanted to add to this hardcore Ironman update is a real sticking point, and something, you know, if you've got an answer to this, I really appreciate you leaving a comment. Upgrading your hatchet. It's very easy to get a steel hatchet as a hardcore Ironman, because you can just buy one from Bob's Axes over in Lumbridge. But the only way to get a better axe than steel, I getting up to that rune hatchet, is to gain favour with one of the houses of Curend and join the Woodcutters Guild, and then you can buy one. Unless you do that, there's really not a lot you can do. I'm doing Wintertodt with a steel axe. Literally, it seems like clue scrolls and a few monsters that drop, say, like a mithril axe seem to be the only way forward. This is something I really want to improve on my account quite quickly, and it's something, it's kind of like an unexpected problem that I've come across with hardcore Ironman. So if you've already solved this problem and you've got a really good method, please leave a comment and let me know how you achieved it. This is something that I'm going to add to my short-term list. And if you remember all the way back with some of my first videos, I wanted that rune hatchet before I even left free-to-play. I thought it'd be easy once you got into members, but actually it's quite hard. So watch this space. If you've enjoyed this video and it has been at all helpful, please like, subscribe, and leave a comment. I, the Lumbridge Knight, am at your service. Until the next time, stay strong, Iron Man.